how I went from nothing and living in a city to this.
But this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. Eminem, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang.
All right, quick shameless plug before I start the video. Don't mind all the paperwork and bills I gotta pay yet, but I'm gonna be live on YouNow when I'm filming this. So if you ever wanna check that out, YouNow.com/DFDev. You can hop in there if I'm on there and talk to me right in the chat and I can answer questions or we can hang out. But the link for that will be in the description. All right, let's get on with the video now. So basically, I've been looking forward to this video for a while. I think my story is pretty interesting. I think, you know, you guys watching it will like it. Basically, to start, I guess I should just kind of explain where I am now to kind of give, you know, some insight on why I'm somewhat qualified to talk about this. So I'm 21 years old. I have my own dairy farm. I milk about 40 cows. I started it when I was 18, technically, but it was 2 weeks before my 19th birthday, so 19. Currently, I own a farm. I rent land, and I own the cows myself, and I do everything myself. I don't have employees or nothing. I have no family farm background. My parents, you know, they didn't farm. No one in my family farmed. And I was from a city in Milwaukee County. So I'll get into that more. As I go through this video, a couple things to keep in mind. I kind of have a list wrote down to get through this video. When it came time for me to make a decision on what I kind of wanted to do, I had no hesitation about anything. And this, I've kind of got an insight from listening to a lot of, you know, motivational people on YouTube or whatever, and just kind of having a drive. But don't hesitate. You know, like, tomorrow's not going to be the day. Next week's not going to be, you know, the week. Next year's not going to be your year. Like, just do it. Today, execute. You know, that's one of my favorite quotes is, you know, the difference between a winner and a loser is a winner executes when they don't feel like it. So after this video, you know, if you have some desire to farm or whatever, now this is not you know, how to do it. This is how I did it. There's a lot of things in here that I would change if I could do it over again. And I will make a video on some of my advice. But basically, I had no hesitation about anything. Everything was do it now. I'm going to do it now. I'm going to do it till it works, and I'm going to make it work. Another thing is I busted ass big time. Everyone said, you know, it's hard and it's this and that. And I'm like, yeah, okay, well, I can handle it, you know. It has been harder than I thought it would be physically, mentally, financially, emotionally, you know, it was harder. I worked harder than I thought I would. And everyone told me, oh, it's hard work. It's hard work. And I'm like, okay, yeah, yeah, yeah. But it's been harder than even, you know, I wasn't pessimistic enough about it. Anyway, to go on about, kind of my past, I guess, so growing up, I grew up Milwaukee County. I don't, I'm not going to get too personal, but Milwaukee County, Wisconsin. You know, it was the city, neighbors, you know, house right next to each other. And I guess I always had an interest in agriculture because my grandma had a cabin about an hour and a half north. And my family would, you know, spend basically all summer up there. And well, at least weekends, and, you know, hunt and fish and this and that. And then there was a neighbor with a farm, and we'd go, and as I grew up, I would help them out and help more and more, you know, making hay and feeding animals and doing this and that. So I had always been around it and always had an interest in it. And my parents had some other friends that had farms that we'd go hang out on. So I had been around it and I had some interest in it. And I never really knew what to do about it. But sophomore year in high school, we had a sit down with the school counselor to kind of talk about your future and planning or whatever. And, you know, they're like, what do you have an interest in? I'm like, well, I'm kind of interested in agriculture. And this is a school in Milwaukee County. So it was, the counselor had no advice for me about what I could do about agriculture. So it was, I wouldn't say discouraging, but, you know, that's what kind of kickstarted a drive where it's like, you know, it made me just want to push harder towards it because just kind of proving people wrong was a good feeling that I got from that. But so that was sophomore year, and then I was there junior year, and then at the end of junior year, my grandma had passed away and that cabin went up for sale, and my parents ended up looking at another place in rural Wisconsin, and they ended up getting it. So I had a chance to move. My dad was gonna still work where we were living, but I had a chance to move if I wanted to, or I could stay and finish my senior year. And I was like, you know, I'm out of here. I'm gonna move and, you know, go get a job on a farm. And that's exactly what I did. You know, we moved up there and I got a job at a neighbor's farm, and it was an old guy and his wife, and they had about 70 cows. And I was the employee. I got paid $8 an hour. And I said, you know, I don't need money. You know, I need experience. So I got a job working. I worked for him that summer and then all of senior year and then the summer after senior year. So about a year and a half I worked for him and learned a lot. Towards the end of the first year of working for him, I was kind of getting my mindset on, you know, this is something I really think I'd want to do. And senior year of high school, I took two classes and then had school to work. So I would go to school for two classes and then go to work for the rest of the day. So I was working a lot and learning a lot. And I kind of decided, you know, this is something I want to do. And I didn't really, I had a lot of interests, but, you know, as a farmer, you kind of get to do everything, you know, take care of animals, run machinery, fix things. You know, you're a mechanic, a welder, a meteorologist most of the time, you know, so I had a lot of interest and I got to do everything being a farmer. So that's I kind of had my mind set on that. So what happened after about a year of working for that guy, so after I graduated high school, I had bought two heifer calves and started raising them. I was dating a girl at the time that had a hobby farm or whatever with a couple horses, you know, and pigs and whatnot. And she ended up letting me keep them over there. So I had them two calves and I raised them until at 2 months old, I had got another one for free from the guy I was working for. So I had three heifer calves that I was raising. And everyone started asking, you know, what do you plan on doing with them? You know, and my answer was always, I'm going to raise them until they're breeding age and then I'm going to breed them. And then when they have a calf, I'm going to have some place to milk them. So that was kind of my mindset. You know, I was like, I'm going to just figure it out, you know. So at the end of the summer, them calves are a couple months old, and I had applied and gotten in to go to UW-Madison Farm and Industry Short Course, which is a 5-month ag program, you know, certificate program. So I headed down there, and the girl I was dating took care of the calves while I was gone. So once I was down there, I took all the classes I could. I took every single business class, which was the most useful, in my opinion, out of the whole program. Short Course is a good program. It's been around for forever, and it's fun if you want it to be fun, and it's useful if you want it to be useful, and it can be both. And everyone says that you get out what you put in through, you know, in regards to short course, what you put into it is what you get out of it, and that's true because I got a lot out of it, and I put a lot of time into, especially the business classes. That was the most important in my opinion. So when I got done with short course, I had 3 heifer calves and some knowledge. I told the guy, my neighbor, that I wasn't going back to work for him, and I started looking for a farm to rent. Now, while I was in short course, I was looking. So I'd already been looking for about 6 months with not much luck, and I was talking to everybody and seeing if anybody had a barn available that I could rent. And then, actually, it was even before short course that I was looking, just to see if I get something lined up. So it was probably like a year that I was looking for a barn to rent, and I was talking to everybody, and just no one had anything. I mean, there's empty barns all over, but nobody wanted to put animals in them again, or nobody wanted to rent them out. There really wasn't any opportunity for me to work in with somebody. There could have been with the neighbor, possibly, but that farm was in his family for over 100 years, and the chance of somebody with a different last name getting it was slim to none. Just based off of what I thought, just from knowing the guy for, you know, 2 years or whatever. But so I searched everywhere and talked to everybody, and I mean, I was comfortable in the area I was in. I was willing to go to different parts of the state or something, but I ended up getting lucky and found a guy with a piece of crap farm. I mean, it was a dump, and it was a single guy, you know. He had no complaints about it really, but it was what it was to him. But it, you know, the neighborhood opinion on the place was that it was kind of run down, which it was. But I ended up talking to him because he was looking to sell the cows and get out and be done with it. And so I went over to talk to him and met him, and I basically talked about renting the barn from him, and he was fine with that, and, you know, said that he'd be willing to sell me the cows and rent me the barn and this and that. So from that point, after that point, I went to the FSA office and started trying to get a cattle loan. And I ended up getting a cattle loan, and I ended up working stuff out with this guy. And I mean, I'm not kidding. This place was the barn. I'm going to put some pictures up and some videos if I got some, but the stalls are small. It was just a barn and a cow yard and like one shed, but he had cows there. He only wanted $300 a month to rent the barn, and he had a skid loader there and a tractor and a manure spreader, so that was all taken care of, and we had worked all that out. And then there was no house there. He had a mobile home that was kind of worn down because he was gonna be moving out anyway to move the town. But the mobile home that was there was not in livable condition. So I ended up getting a camper to live in. But anyway, so I got a cattle loan. I bought the cows from him, and I took over, started renting this barn. And I spent hours. It was a grade B barn, you know, just to give some perspective of the quality of it. It was grade B. I had a put in hours of work cleaning it up, and you know, got it up to grade A. So passed inspection, bought the cows, got my loan, all that went through. And then I needed some place to live because I didn't want to be driving. This was probably 20 minutes from where I was living, so I didn't want to be driving 20 minutes every day, or, you know, twice a day to milk and stuff. So I ended up buying a camper, a 30-foot camper, and put that on the farm, and that's what I lived in for the year and a half that I was there, was a 30-foot camper. It had heat and air conditioning. The heat ran off propane, and it was not, you know, those aren't insulated the greatest, so it used the propane up real quick. Me and my dad actually ended up putting a wood-burning stove in it, drilled a hole in the roof, put a chimney out, and I burned wood that winter. And I don't know, it was a fun experience, but I definitely prefer a house over, you know, a little camper in a Wisconsin winter. So anyway, about a year went by on this farm and I made it through winter and spring went good. I bought all my feed except for haylage. I made my own haylage. I had bought a New Holland 499 haybine, and then that girl I was dating, I borrowed her dad's tractor to cut hay. So I cut my own hay and raked it myself, and then I had someone else chop it, and then I would help them bag it. So that's what I did. I bought the rest of my feed, and then I just handled my own haylage on rented hay ground. So winter was coming up. I was not on good terms with the landlord because he had steers there and they were getting out, and he didn't want to make any repairs, like structure wise, you know, stuff to the actual barn and stuff, because he just didn't care about the place anymore. So we weren't on good terms and it was kind of falling apart, and it wasn't the best place to begin with. But so I was basically, you know, and I was not having a good time milking my cows there. I mean, it was rough, and I was not looking forward to another winter there because it was hell the year before. And you know, even down to the barn cleaner, it was just, the barn cleaner would hardly work the way it was supposed to. But so I was looking at a couple decisions: if I can find another barn to rent before winter, if I can work something out maybe with the guy that I worked for in high school, or, you know, if I can find someone else, somewhere to take the cows, or, you know, do I just sell them? And I mean, I had a loan and I paid in a year or over a year, you know, I could sell them and, you know, the loan would be paid off. It could have worked that way too. So I was kind of facing this decision, and, you know, I was just getting by doing what I was doing. And I should probably add, keep in mind, I was working off the farm the whole time. I had worked for an oil change place in town for a while, and then I had worked at a neighbor's farm that they had 1,400 cows, and I worked there doing maintenance and stuff. So I was milking my own, and then I was working off the farm as well, like 4 to 5 hours a day. And I kept talking around and talking around to see if I can find somewhere to go. And the lady that I buy chemicals from for the milk house, so soap acid and teat dip, she actually had a friend that was farming about 15 minutes away from me that had recently been going through a divorce, and they had just built the freestyle barn with the barn, and they did have a robot, but they were getting a divorce and they were selling everything. Well, I ended up getting my home loan through Badgerland, but I was in at Badgerland, and I was working with them, and they needed a cosign, so my parents were generous enough to cosign. But that's how I came about this place. The loan process went fairly smooth and relatively quick. But so now I've been here for coming up on a year now. It hasn't been easy, but it's been fun. I mean, I'm kind of enjoying my time. My social life is non-existent compared to pretty much anybody my age. I mean, I have a social life, but compared to other people, I don't. I've worked every day straight for the last almost 2.5 years now. I think it's like 2 years and 5 months, but every single day, twice a day, I've milked for the last 2.5 years. But so if that has anything to say about it. But anyway, I'm gonna have another video at some other point about, you know, what I kind of do differently and my advice for somebody that wants to start, you know, if they have nothing, or maybe it's in their family or something. But anyway, this is part of the DFD Daily series where I set out a goal to post a video every day for a year about what goes on during my every day, and kind of inform and give people insight on what goes on a farm every day. So if you want to subscribe to the channel, that way you can know when I post, either if you want to see that video about my advice to other people or the tour of the farm, subscribe and you can see that. Or if you want to just keep up to date with what is going on here every day and what's going on the farm every day, then you can subscribe. Otherwise, like the video if you liked it. Leave me a comment. If you got any questions, just leave them in the comments. I'll answer every single one of them. Or you could message me through social media, Twitter or Instagram or something, which those will be in the description. But I mean, that's about it. It's not really a fancy story. I mean, it's not really much to it, just a lot of hard work and kind of, well, like I said, lining things up and taking advantage of opportunities when they come to you, and, you know, not hesitating and just doing. So thanks for watching. I hope you found it interesting. Until tomorrow.